Hi, good evening, Nana here. In this record, we are going to see about the chipset, which has undergone a change from 19C onwards. So what they have done is, there are three types of sets are there, chipset, arrival set, and then fulfillment set as far as EBS is concerned. So they have all been coupled into only one set as chipset now. We're going to see about how it's been done. It is an enhancement when compared to EBS now. So it's an excellent feature, and then this has now come in Fusion now. So go there. Let me go on and log in and then show it to you. So let me go to the product management, and then I go to the product information management. I now created three items now for demonstrating this now. Click on it, and then I go to the what's called here. I am in the okay. I go there. So I'm gonna click on it. I will now go to what's called create and manage items. This got slightly changed actually. I don't know whether I have gone to the product or not. I will now go to the product management. I will go to the product. I go to the product information management. I may have gone wrong here. I click on it. So yeah, I've gone to the wrong area. So here I go to the product information management. Fine, that was. And then here you can also click on the browse items, and then I'm going to query an item. So here the item starts on A01. A01 is the start. You're going to see I create multiple items now. For this case, what I'm going to have is what I'm going to have a keyboard and mouse as well as desktop and monitor, and then I'm going to have a 2-year extended warranty actually. If you go down and see. We having a 2-year extended warranty. So these three items we're going to demonstrate now. Right? Let us now go on and have a look at that. A desktop and monitor. Click on it now. Open it up and then have a look at it. It's a very simple item. It's not having any change. I applied the finished good template, and then after they go into the specifications, and then you go to the inventory. Everything is SSS now. And the sales and order management. If you go there, back to back is no. And then it's customer order enabled as well as customer order. And then if you go to the planning. You can now see the MRP planning would have been enabled now. So if it is enabled, that means what we can very well collect, and then we can even promise the customers actually what is a simple item. And then similarly, I have a keyboard and mouse, desktop and monitor is one item, and then I have a keyboard and mouse now. So there's a similar item like a desktop and monitor. And then afterwards, I'll now show you the extended warranty. Fine. This is only a billable item. Fine, it's only a billable item, it's not a shippable item. If you go there, click on it. I'll open up the master and show it to you. So through the extended warranty, you go to the specifications now. And then I go to the sales and order management and have a look at it now. And now remove the shippable. So shippable is no. Before you remove the shippable, what you have to do is you have to make the internally transferable no. Once when you make internally transferable no, the internal transfer order enabled will also be no. And then afterwards you save, and then afterwards only you have to make the shippable as no. Remember, fine. If you do in this order, then only it will save, otherwise it will be giving you a problem now. So if the shippable is no, before you make the shippable is no, make these two things as no, and then afterwards what happens is save, and then make the shippable as no. So the thing is it's not done, and then it is now associated. All the three items are associated to the 01 off. And then we'll now go to the sales order, and then we'll have a demonstration of this. So if you done that. So let me go on and create a sales order for this one. Click on the home icon, I go to the order management, and then I go to the order management again. And then let us now create a sales order for demonstrating this ship set actually. Click on create order. Drop it down. And then I'm going to use the use one business unit. Customer is computer services and rentals. Put it in front of the, put the first item A01 and then give it back. So the desktop and monitor. So desktop and monitor, I'm putting it on the go for two items now. Make it for say, three items. I'm going to click on add. I'm going to add it. And then the next item is I will add the keyboard and mouse. A01. Keyboard and mouse. Click on OK. We'll also have it as a three items. The third item is basically a billable item, it is not a shippable item. And go that. So it's a A01 with a 2-year extended warranty. So click on it. So click on it. And then afterwards, since I'm not setting the ATP now, and so that the GOP, so I have to provide the arrows over here. If I go to the supply, and then I will not provide the arrows 001. So go there. I will not give a save at this stage. No, they're not going in the draft mode. No. Now, the arrows which are specified at the header level will be applicable for all the line levels. Now, what happens, we can even very well modify the line level arrows is no point. There's a common one point where I click on it. And the first line, I go there, click on this no point. I have added this column ship set. Fine. The ship set has been added. Previously, what happens, it was not there. So in the view, and then with the columns, what happens if you go there, and then you can now see the ship set is added. So how to add it, you'll now go there, and then click on it no point. Go to the manage columns. And then it will be there on the left-hand side. No point, you have to bring it to that also. So it has been added over here. So the ship set has been added over here. So on the left-hand side, what happens, you have to bring it to the right-hand side. These are the visible columns now. Ship chart, the shipment set is there. Shipment set. It was in this side. What happens, it has been brought over here. Point, like they add, so click on it, and then here, what happens, you go there. And then line-wise, we can very well make a change of the arrows. If I click on this override order line now. So click on it, and then click on override order line. So you can very well change. If you go to the supply, you can very well make a change of the arrows. For each and every line, you can have a different arrows. And go to the general ledger. The shipping also, we can make a change. Now here, I know we are going to concentrate on the ship center. Drop it down. And then click on create now. I'm not going to make a create now. I will now say it's a SS1. So these ship sets are within the org. No, fine. It is not across org. So multiple sales orders can have the same SS1. And click on OK. By which, whatever, we have now created a ship set for the first line. Similarly, go to the drop down and then click on it. And then click on override order line now. And then I'm going to add it. If I drop down, we already created it. You know, show, you know. So choose it. And then click on OK. Now, the first two lines, what the customer or the, what the company says is that the desktop and monitor, if you ship it to the customers, what you can do without a keyboard and mouse, you can only do a ching chong bhajani. Nothing can be done. Fine. So we have to ship together. So whenever you're shipping it, what happens? You have to ship together. So that is why we have put these two things as a ship. The third line is an extended warranty. Fine, I'm not just leaving it as a chip. So I won't give a same now. And then let me go on then. What happens? Submit the sales order. 973671, I'm going to submit it now. Once when you submit it, it will not. Once again, but I made a mistake again. Anyway, I will now show you. Because they have a default, what happens, transaction type. The do has been made a change actually. And it is not a generic process which is now getting fired. So we must see about how it's progressing actually. Professional. So it's now processing now. You click on it, actions, and then you go to the switch to fulfill view, and then you know have a look at it now. Now it's now processing, and go back on it. And then I click on refresh now. It will be getting scheduled, and then it will be getting reserved, and then it will be going to the finally awaiting shipping. So the activity is now happening now. So the first two lines are put on a shipment set, and so what happens that we cannot ship it. What happens partially? There is one item can be shipped, other items cannot be shipped. That you are going to see now. I am going to the fulfillment side, and then have a look at it. Click on the fulfillment. And then click on the do number now. Remember that all of them are having the same do number now. The final one is having a different do number, 5656 and then 35, because what happens, this is going to be interfaced to what the AR actually. There's no schedule, it's not started. The final number is now having the same do as a different do now. You click on it. So click on refresh now. But since it is a ship order generic process, it is not going to interface it to AR. So that's why it is not coming. It is not fine. Let me make a change of this to order flow generic process. So that what happens, it will be getting triggered to the AR actually. So the first two lines, which belongs to the same do number now, the same do number are now getting scheduled, reserved, and then what happens, refresh it. And then if you go there, it's now going to the waiting shipping. So the final one has not started because of the ship order generic process. Because the ship order generic process will never get interfaced to AR at all. So it will never get interfaced. So it is okay, fine, it's gone. Okay, good. It is not gone waiting. So it's good. So now what happens is that if these two things are shipped or not, it is now eligible for a what's called a billing. Fine. But if the company says that what happens is this 2-year warranty should be billed only after you ship these two items. So in which case, what happens, we have to put all the three lines on a fulfillment selection. So fulfillment is what? Shipping has to be completed. Then only what happens, the extended warranty, the 2-year additional warranty has to be billed. Now, it has already got billed. It has already been interfaced with billing. So what we are going to do in EBIS, what we have to do is we have to put these two lines in a ship set And then all the three lines on a fulfillment center. Now it is not required here. In Fusion, what happens if you put all the three lines on a ship set, that is more than sufficient. This will never get interfaced to AR at all. So we are going to see this now. So let us know. 97367, let me, what happens? I'll copy this order. Click on the, you go to the actions, and then in the main line, what happens? You go to the copy. And 97367, I'm going to copy now. I will know. Select everything. I'm going to click on select all. Which, what happens? I'm going to copy everything. Click on create an edit order. The new orders, no thing. It's not going to freeze the prices and shipping charges. It's okay. Fine. Doesn't matter. Click on it. The warning message is coming. Accept the warning message. But then 97367 will be getting copied into 97368 actually. And go that point. And then before I process whatever they go there, you know, make a, I have made a default do. Point. So what happens? My default generic process will be triggered actually. And then here, whatever they know, go to the place. And then I go to the shipment area. I click on the shipments area. And then here we have a header level. Varrows, no fine. If you want, you can even make a change to the values. Here, I will now add the third line also to the same section. So that what happens, it will never interface to AR at all upon before shipping. So I click on override line and then let me add it. You're not getting error, no fine. You're not fine. Your warning attribute value of the values will not represent the values. Okay. Do you want to continue? Will be replaced with the other shank and click on okay. Anyway, it's not going to be shipped. It doesn't matter. So you're not changing it. Now all the three are now done. The shipping method is not applicable because it is not a shippable product. It's only a billable product. And so shipping method is not applicable. So all the three belongs to the same ship set. So this means what? The ship set and then the fulfillment set have been coupled together in Fusion. And there's a good one. No need to have a separate fulfillment set at all. Go there. 97368 is the one. And go there. So click on it and then you'll know. The quantity is only one. I don't know. I made a mistake, I think probably. I should have given three as such. Okay, doesn't matter. We are only going to see that what's called that. How it's going to do. Maybe what happens for all the three put together, it may be only one. Fine. Doesn't matter. You just make a check of it. So 97368 is the one. I'm not submitting it for it. Now the third line will not be interfaced to billing at all. Can you see? So click on the first one. No, it is getting interfaced on this place. And then go to the actions and then go to the switch to fulfillment view. No. We are switching to the fulfillment view and then you can have a look at it now. Go there. So it is not going to start. It is not created now. It is not coming as a created. And go there, click on it. So again, I have not put the proper do only thing. Click on refresh now. So if you go there, you cannot see. It will not be going into this area. So it's not created. So in the meantime, what happens? You'll now go on and have a look at the behavior of the ship set now. Click on it. And then have a look at the behavior of the ship. I will not make it as a warning now. First, I will make it as a warning. Go there, click on it, and then go there. And then you go to the setup and maintenance, and then you know, go to the task, manage shipping parameters. No? And then click on it. You will make it the fine. Click on search. No? 1 second. So it's manage percentage, ship percentage, para percentage, and entering. Manage shipping parameters. What is a mistake? Manage shipping parameters. What is this place? So I'm in this organization 001. Okay. For the 001, you can now see the behavior of the ship set. Behavior of the ship set is error now. So let me make it as a warning. So that means what? It will now warn you that you are not trying to break the ship set, but it will now allow you to ship it. The ship set behavior is warning. And click on save and close. Now we will now see about how it's going to behave. And then we will now refresh this thing. We will now see about how it's getting progressing. Go there and see this. So here, what happens? It is now going to awaiting shipping. So these two lines are going to awaiting shipping, but it is only created. It is not going to awaiting billing at all. It is not going to awaiting billing. Click on it. And then refresh again. No. Now let us go there and then try to ship the product. So the order number is what? You can now see the order number. My 97368. Now I'm going to click on it. I will now open up one more tab region and then we'll now try to ship it. Go there. So I will now go to the supply chain execution and then here I will now go to the inventory management. Supply chain execution and now go to the inventory management. In this place, we go there. And then click on it and then you go to the shipment lines, you know, drop it off and then go to the shipments and then go to the shipment lines. Manage shipment lines, you're able to make a query now. 9736 8 is the one. So 97368 is the one. And then I make it as before. Some days. And then I don't make a search. So we are searching it fine over that. Both the lines are coming. So what I will do is I will now create the first line and I will now create a shipment number now for this one. First line I will create a shipment. So click on auto create shipments for the first line. I'm now creating a shipment. Remember, and not for the second line. So I have now created it. Now let me do the pick release now. Pick release will not fully work. We have a sufficient stock in the inventory, and so pick release will not have any problem at all. And go to the actions and go to pick release. It will get picked. And it is a very simple item. It's not having any serial or lot control or revision control. Fine. It gets picked automatically. And then we are seeing various combinations of this in the shipping area about different controls and then how the OR parameters are also going to come into picture. Now it will be progressing to stage lecture. You don't have any issues. And then you don't have to know that. So if you go there and then make a search again, the first line will be progressing to what stage lecture. It is not ready to place, no, it's on stage. Now, if I try to ship confirm, what happens, it will not give only a warning because we are now breaking the ship set. So first is the desktop and monitor, and then here the next item is what? Keyboard and mouse. So we are supposed to ship together, and then what happens, you are not trying to break the ship set. If I click on it, it will not give a warning. If you click on it, what happens, you click on the ship confirmation, what happens, a warning will be coming. So it's a warning. The ship confirm request has warnings on the shipment set selected on the shipment. So is it one or more shipment sets of the shipment of the order are incomplete actually? Do you really want to continue? The weight and volume. The next one is the weight and volume. There's the weight and volume. Weight and volume is okay. Fine. That is only for the transportation management. But it says what? That it is now going to break. No, is a warning. So if you want like this, what happens? We can even put it like this, and then we can even is a warning message for the shipment man, and then he will not decide. The customer says, "Arey yaar, kam se kam ek to bejo." Fine. Like this is asking for, then what happens? You will not prefer a warning. But if you want to error it out. Probably you know, make a check. No, no, fine. Let us know. Change it to error. No, and click on it in this place. You go to the manage shipment parameters, and then here I have no ship set behavior. I'm going to make it as what error information is also there. Fine. I know the warning. I'm moving into the error. So click on save, and then save and close. No, you know that. And go back, and then here I will know re-query. Make a cancel, and then I have to re-query it. Then it won't be properly working. Fine. Go and click on it. Let us know re-query this now. Click on search. No. Now, if I go and then try to, what happens, ship confirm, fine, click on it. Fine, I'm going to go there. And then you click on ship confirmation, triple A. Warning message has come, fine, click on ship confirmation now, fine. It sounds like it's again coming as a warning. It has to come as an error, actually, no. It is not sensed, actually. You have to cancel. You may have to, what happens, wait for some time before the parameters are basically done. Remember, there is no need to collect and refresh whenever you make any changes in the shipping area. No, it is not required. It has to throw me an error. If you click on shipment information, it has to throw me an error. Fine, error. Oda ponga. I will not allow you at all. Fine. The ship confirmation request. Fine. There is no yes and no. Fine. There's no all this. Fine. You cannot ship it because what happens? The ship. We are not trying to break the ship. So you can decide whether to have a warning or otherwise error depending upon the company's policy. Fine. Go there. Click on it. Fine. It's not allowing error. No. So now what happens? The second one also, I will not do this one. I will click on it. I will not choose the second one. And then I will now add it to the what's called the same shipment number. Fine, click on select it and then click on add to shipment now. So 46198 is the shipment number. Let me add it. 46198 and then go tab and then click on query now. I will now add the same shipment. Fine, select it and then click on add now. Fine, we're getting added. So no, both of them belong to the same ship set. Fine, go there. So I will now keep my custom the first one. It is already staged. Fine, keep the custom the second one and then we'll move on to the request. So the second line also will be pick released from the finished good area, and then it will be brought to the staging now. So click on it. So the concurrent is not completed. Fine, is not running. So wait for the concurrent to complete, and then once when the ESS job gets completed, what happens? You'll be able to see this also is staged. The enterprise scheduler service job is now running. So now it's now staged. Now, if you try to confirm, what happens, it will be getting confirmed. Click on it, now, fine. Now both are staying, now, fine. So since they belong to the same ship set, what happens, they go there. And then if you click on ship confirmation, there will not be any problem at all. So it's not giving a warning, fine, go there, it's not, because what happens here, the ship set is not coming as a warning. The weight and volume is having a warning. The weight and volume, and then the weight and volume. It doesn't matter. We are not given any weight and volume. That is required only for the transportation management. So this is what it is, a generic statement, fine. So all the three are basically weight and volume only, fine. Okay, okay, click on yes, no, fine. They're accepting it. And then what happens, it will go hard. So it is now shipped now. And then now what happens, a concurrent will be running for send shipment advice will be running now. Fine. That will be interfacing the shipment into order entry actually. Fine. and then you go to the schedule process and see, wait for the concurrent to complete now. The send shipment advice is basically responsible for what happens. Communicating the shipment to the back to the order entry from the shipment area now. And then my students had problems on the printing of these pick slips. Now find whether we had to appropriately see which document has to be printed. Fine. Again, I don't know how to do them. They were struggling like anything on the ship confirmation documents because they are attaching some AR invoices, some pro forma invoices and other things. Fine, they're not getting completed properly in the field actually. If anybody knows about how to attach various documents, the ship confirmation documents on printing, right? So please tell me. And then you can always write to me for any of the clarifications to my, I can also visit my website, oraclenona.com, and then join the discussion form over there. There are many subject matter experts there, so they'll be solving your problems if you have, if you post your question, what happens, somebody may even answer you. So please join there, and then you can even contact by my mobile number, and then you can even write to me at this mail area, oraclenona.com. Go there. And then, now, the send shipment advice is now completed. Once it is completed, what happens, you can see the sales order will be getting updated. Space. And then if you click on refresh, what happens, you cannot see, there will be an update on this one. Keep on it. Go there, go down, and then drag it down. So it is not shipped, fine. It is not created, it is not shipped. And then now what happens, it will now go to the awaiting billing. All the three will now go to the awaiting billing. Right? If you click on refresh, now you cannot see, all the three will be going to the awaiting billing. Go further now. It is now awaiting, all of them are going to awaiting billing. So after these two are shipped, what happens there? So it behaves like what? Ship set, come fulfillment set, club together basically. The both of them are clubbed together because of the ship. It's an excellent announcement in the party. Eve is not fine. What else? So this completes the demonstration of the ship set, and then the ship set as well as the fulfillment set put together. For any what happens, any of your queries, you can write to me at nana at oraclenana.com. There's a new mail ID. There is a website actually. You can write to me. Right? So let me wish you a prosperous career in Fusion Apps. So bye for now. Do visit my website, oraclenona.com. Bye for now.